Hello everyone, welcome back to 3D CAD tutorials. Today we'll model a very simple component. If you not yet subscribed to our channel, please like, share and subscribe to our channel. Here we are having a very simple isometric view. So if we have to select in such a way, what are major feature has to be covered in the first sketch? This we have to keep in mind when we are modeling a existing drawing. If it's a conceptual, you don't know which feature will come after that. Once you are changing your ideas, it will be changed, the feature will get changed, so you can't tell the exact feature will come here. But here it is a defined shape. When you are got a defined shape, you have to draw a sketch in such a way the maximum features has to be covered in the main sketch. So here if you take this one, if I sketch in the right plane and if I extrude this one, maybe like this, this is not at all useful, because one more time I have to draw this one and this one, and also I have to cut this one, I have to extrude these two, and I have to cut this one, and afterwards I have to do extrude this one as well. So it's better to draw this one, but instead of drawing only this much, what I will do, instead of this much, I will take the bottom view. I will take the bottom view. That means I will draw the sketch of this one and I will extrude this one first. Then this feature will be covered, this feature will be covered. Then second one, I will just cut this one at an angle and I will extrude this one. So 1, 2, and 3 step will cover this one. Let us go to SolidWorks. Please take a screenshot if you required for practicing. We are moving to SolidWorks. So now we are in SolidWorks. So what I will do, I will just go through the sketch in a very fast way, because we I explained in a last video, 4 or 5 videos in a detailed way. I am going to top sketch, top insert sketch in top plane and draw a sketch in top plane. What I will do, as I told earlier, I am using a dynamic mirror here to complete my sketch in a faster way. I will select these tools, go to tools, sketch tools, then go to mirror, dynamic mirror, then we got this one. I am drawing sketch in a rough manner. Okay, done. It is a closed circuit, then what I will do, once it's closed, I am giving this dimension. They are specified this as 40 millimeters. This is 40 millimeters. And they are specifying from here to here it is 94 millimeters. And they are specifying this one as 30 millimeters. And the width of the this one is 20 millimeters, and the thickness of this one they are specifying as 13 millimeters. Sorry, we have to keep in a proper way. Okay, so the overall width of the component they are telling 60 millimeters. So let us check the given. So here 94, 60 and 40, 30, 20, and they are given it as a 20. Once we achieve 20 and 20, it will automatically come there, otherwise 60, it will automatically come. So I am moving here, see here 60, because of this is center, no need to provide the 20. So I am just extruding this one to 57 millimeters. Now I don't want in the mid plane blind, I am using 57 millimeters. 57 millimeters, even though the right plane is at center, because I draw the sketch in top plane. So afterwards what I will do, I will take this face, insert sketch, make normal to just draw a sketch, this sketch to maintain this one, this angular cut is there now. To maintain this one I am doing this cut. So here, from here to here, they are claiming this is 10 millimeters, 10 millimeters, and from here to here 45 millimeters, from here to here is 45 millimeters. So this edge coincide with the line endpoints, so it's automatically constrained. So go to features, cut extrude, then take it as up to next, or you can take it as through all. Okay, then select this face and insert sketch. The given dimension is as per this 35 by 20, 35 by 20, from the edge it is 10. Okay, I am drawing this one. So thirty-five millimeters and 20 millimeters. So we can centralize, as I told earlier, we can draw a central line from this one to this center and give the relationship as vertical. It will automatically constrain. As they are given, this is 10 millimeters from this edge. I am providing as 10 millimeters. Okay, then here where we can use this one as a two directional extrude. One is the first one. If you go here, from the surface it is projecting out 15 millimeters and the inside up to this surface. So we have to first direction I will use 15 millimeters, and in second direction just click and say up to next. It will take automatically up to the surface, or you can say up to surface, and you can say this one it will take. So both the ways you can try this one. Okay, so the required model is ready. Now this is the, as per the given dimension we model this one. I think you understood this one. Thanks for watching. If you not yet subscribed, please like, share and subscribe to our channel. Please encourage. Thank you.